Dr. Kristi Ferguson is Professor Emeritus of Internal Medicine and former Director of the Office of Consultation and Research in Medical Education at the University of Iowa Carver College of Medicine. She spent her entire postgraduate career as an educational consultant and researcher at the University of Iowa. Kristi received her Bachelor of Arts degree from Concordia College in 1971 and continued her education at the University of Michigan, where she earned her master's degree and doctorate. She started at the University of Iowa in 1983 and has received more than 30 grants, presented at 6 national conferences, and published more than 100 peer-reviewed articles. Over the course of 30 years, Kristi contributed to major curriculum revisions in the College of Medicine, including the New Horizons curriculum, innovations in problem-based learning and the learning communities, and establishing a master's in medical education program. Over the course of her career, she received many honors. Kristi was twice awarded the Collegiate Teaching Award for her outstanding dedication to education. She was also awarded the Distinguished Laureate Award from the Central Group on Educational Affairs, the Arthritis Foundation Health Professions Fellowship, and the Veterans Administration Health Services Research Predoctoral Fellowship. As executive producer of the Barbara Fassbinder story, Kristi earned several awards, including the Cine Golden Eagle Award, the Red Ribbon from the American Film and Video Association in the Health Professional category, and the Best Education Documentary Video from Movies to Go, Iowa Film Awards. Kristi has served on committees of several regional and national organizations, including the Association of American Medical Colleges and the Society of Directors of Research in Medical Education. During her service, she held many positions, including Member at Large, Chair Elect, and Chair. Throughout her exceptional career, Kristi maintained strong ties with Concordia and the beloved friends she met at the college. She even wrote a book, Friends for Life, about her orientation friends. They met during their first week at the college and have maintained connections over the years and the miles. Kristi remains involved in her church and community. She has assisted Zion Lutheran Church of Iowa City in many capacities. Most recently, she was elected as vice chair of the board of directors of the Lutheran School of Theology in Chicago.
I'd like to thank the Alumni Association for this wonderful recognition. For as long as I can remember, I wanted to attend a Lutheran college. Having experiences at Luther Crest, Camp Vermillion, and the National Youth Gathering in Detroit before my sophomore year in high school convinced me that this would be the right choice for me. My parents were a little concerned as I would not turn 18 until December of my freshman year, and they thought I was a little young to go away to college. Finances were also a concern, but I was able to get financial aid from Concordia and finished all 4 years here. I was fortunate my freshman year to meet 5 women who had become my lifelong friends. We started out together in Park Region, then lived in Bishop Whipple Hall, and moved off campus for our final 2 years. We attended Concordia from 1967 to 1971, which was a very turbulent time in our nation's history. The Vietnam War was ever present with the nightly body count on the news. And Martin Luther King was assassinated in April of our sophomore year, so racial tensions were running high. Religion professors, including Lester Meyer, Donald Luck, and James Haney, helped me understand the role of faith in such troubled times. I decided to major in sociology, and courses from Lawrence Falk helped me understand the importance of the social context and understanding individual and social issues. Norbert Benzel and his love for his fatherland and the German language encouraged me to also get a second major in German. Music and theater events helped break up the weekly classes, and attending sporting events on weekends made Saturday classes less of a drag. After graduation, I went to the University of Michigan and got a Master of Social Work degree. My first position as a medical social worker involved educating the team about the social context and family support of our patients, and my experience at Concordia had served me well in preparing me for that aspect of my role. 3 years after that, I got a PhD from the University of Michigan School of Public Health to have a more formal role in teaching. I went from there to the University of Iowa Carver College of Medicine to work in an office that supported faculty in their role as teachers. I especially like small group teaching, and my experience at Concordia likely contributed to that, as we had many small classes and lively discussion. When I became the director of that office, we started a master's in medical education degree program, and 41 people have graduated from that program since its beginning. My interest in teaching extended beyond my professional life, and I taught Sunday school for my sons in second grade, seventh grade, and 11th grade, which I was doing when 9/11 hit. That experience brought back many memories from experiences at Concordia, and my class decided to write a letter of condolence to the family of one of the people who was killed in the attack on the Pentagon, who happened to be from Iowa City. I have many people to thank along the way. My roommates taught me how to have fun, how to think about seriously about just about anything, and to live frugally but feel very rich. Concordia professors taught me the importance of asking questions and not taking things at face value. My graduate school professors taught me about the importance of evidence and how to evaluate its quality. My husband stayed at home with our children as I started my career, and his role as a stay-at-home dad helped me tremendously in transitioning back to the workforce, and his support throughout my career meant a great deal to me. Pastors along the way, including Ann Svenningson, Mike Burke, and Mark Priest, taught me how to live faithfully outside the four walls of the church, just as I had learned at Concordia.